When you look at the night sky, you really can tell how distant different stars or objects are. And that's simply because of their great distance from us. We don't know, we have a feeling, for instance, if you see a human being at some distance, then you can roughly sort of make an educated guess about the distance. Why? Because you know how tall the person is, and it appears small because he's at a distance, so you can gauge roughly what the distance is. In the case of celestial objects like stars or planets, there's no way to do that. Okay? So all we can specify is the angular distance between two objects in the sky. So what I mean by angular distance, say this is the moon and a star. So what you can determine is this so-called angular distance, which is nothing but the angle between the line connecting your eye and the moon, and the other line which connects your eye with the star. So that angle is what we call the angular distance. So, of course, the angles could be measured precisely with the instruments, but you don't need the instruments to make an estimate as to how big an angle is. For instance, there are simple rules to gauge that. So, for instance, if you extend your arm, your finger subtends an angle of about 1 degree. If you spread all five from one end to another, it's about 20 degrees. Closed fist is roughly half of that, 10 degrees. Now, this is very approximate. It depends on the size of one's hand, thickness of the fingers, this and that. But it's good enough to estimate the ballpark values. Okay, so for instance, here you can determine that the distance between these two so-called pointer stars in the Big Dipper. Remember, if you continue in this direction and look at the star that is at the end of the handle of the Little Dipper, that's what the Polaris is. So the angle between these two pointer stars is, the angular distance between them is 5 degrees. The angular size of the moon and the sun is actually the same. And it just the way nature conspires for these two angular distances to be the same. The angular size of the moon is about 0.5 degree, and the angular size of the sun is also 0.5 degree. And what is happening, I mentioned before that the distance between us and the moon is about 400,000 kilometers, 384 to be more precise. And the distance between us and the sun is 150 million kilometers, 400 times bigger. Okay? So the distance between us and the sun is 400 times the distance between us and the moon. But it happens also that the diameter of the sun is 400 times bigger than the diameter of the moon. The sun is about 100 times bigger than the Earth in diameter, and the diameter of the Earth is about 4 times the diameter of the moon. So the ratio of diameter of the sun and diameter of the moon is 400. So their distances from us are in the same proportion as their diameters. And as a result, they appear to have the same angular size. Now, there's another purely psychological effect that when you look at the moon, it appears to all of us, for the reasons that are not quite well understood still, it's one of the puzzles, that when you look at the moon and it just it has just risen. It's close to the horizon. Everybody would swear that it looks bigger than when it is high up in the sky. But you can actually do the measurement of angular size and see that actually there is no difference. And one theory is that when the moon is low to the horizon, it appears bigger to us because we see it close to the objects such as trees or houses whose size we are aware of their size, okay? We have a feeling for how big trees and houses are, okay? And it looks to us as if it is kind of comparable in size to them. It's purely when it's way up in the sky, not close to anything on the surface, right? There is nothing to compare it with. So our brain interprets that as if it's smaller than when it's low in the horizon, but it is not. It is not. Its orbit is roughly circular, so its distance from the Earth is always roughly the same. It doesn't come closer to us much. So that is just the way our brain plays trick on us, that the moon, when it's low in the horizon, looks to be bigger than when it is high up in the sky.